Are you ready for some roller derby? It's my great pleasure to bring out the team in white, the Mountain Mavens, representing the Gorge Roller Girls. Let's start with number 10, Jack Rabbit. 182, Carmen El Recchia. 2.7, Psycho Kinesis. 29, Scoldy Knox. Number 33, Helda Contempt. 42, Feisty. Their captain for 32, Tantrum. Number 7, Judo Chop. Number 84, Stab Cynthy. Number 88, Jinx. Number 9, Kung Fu Lu. 92, Anti-Mame. Boom, B00M, Mindestructible. And B52, J-Bomb. Let's put your hands together for the Mountain Mavens.
Intro. And it is my pleasure to introduce to you this evening from right here in Portland, Oregon, make some noise for your Rose City Wreckers! Starting off with number 0, that's Zero Master. Number 1010, Slow Loris. Number 1055, Abracadaver. Number 123, that's Cracker. Coming in at 2 a.m., that's Drive By Lava. Number 20 and your team captain, Shell Puddlewelton. Number 214, V-Day Massacre. Number 23, Colonel Corn. Number 249, Slamrocks. Number 26, Shimmy Coco Bop. Number 32, Lauren Furser. Number 4, say hello to Spectre Gadget. Number 483, Doof Warrior. Number 578, Kitka. Number 630, Rodent of Unusual Size. Number 75, Sci-Fi Curious. Number 76, Halitosis. Number 8008, Resting Blitz Face. And coming in at W88, say hello to Venus Give it up for your Rose City Wreckers! All right, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to get this bout underway. Just a quick note here, we've got more folks coming in, so if you can, squeeze together, love your neighbor. We're all family here, make room for everyone. And we have got the girls lining up on that Ron Tonga jammer line.
For the Mountain Mavens, it's number 7, Judo Chop. Looking like she's gonna line up against Abracadaver.
And if you're new to roller derby, this is how it goes. The jammers are the ones with the stars on their helmets. They score the points. The rest of them are blockers, and they try to stop their opposing jammer. First pass through the pack is for the jammer, and that goes to Abracadaver of the Wreckers.
Oh, Judo Chop really getting caught up there in the pack. The Wreckers doing a nice job of locking her down. Steps out, has to start again. Nice positional blocking there. Judo Chop just not able to make any progress.
Now after that first initial pass, the jammer on her second and subsequent passes will get 1 point for each individual opponent she passes. Picking up a 5-point grand slam, there is Abracadaver.
Oh, Judo Chop still trying to make it through. Getting knocked out and dragged way back, having to reset and start again. There she goes, finally through to the inside.
Abracadaver setting herself in the penalty box for a cutting track penalty. If you get knocked out of bounds and re-enter in front of the pack, that's a track cut. You will spend 30 seconds in the penalty box to think about what you've done.
Oh, there we go, Judo Chop on in a power jam. She's the only jammer on the track, so she's the only one scoring points. 4 points there in that last pass, even with getting a nice block by Shell, put a welt on. Now back to the pack, looking for some daylight, knocked out, ready to start again. It's Mindestructible looking to clear a path through the pack for her.
This jam will go the full 2 minutes as Abracadaver went to the box, but she's out. Picking up 4 more points on that first pass through out of the box.
There we go, another 5-point pass for Judo Chop. Looking to the outside, making some space.
Abracadaver going down, trying to call it off, but that's going to be the full 2 minutes. 4 more points for the Rose City Wreckers there.
Now that each jam is 2 minutes long, that one went the distance. The jammer who is in the lead with the ref is making an L shape, they could actually call that jam off whenever they want. Here we go, it is B52 J-Bomb for the Mountain Mavens.
Taking on number 75, that's Sci-Fi Curious for the Wreckers. And that's the whistle, and Sci-Fi Curious takes advantage of that little bit of confusion there, picking up lead jammer right off the bat.
Oh, there, J-Bomb. Nice bump by Slow Loris. Trying to make it through, one to beat. She does. She is now through. The pack's going to set up here in that second turn. Oh, nicely done there.
Sci-Fi Curious picking up her points there. Calling off the jam.
You know, number 33 held a contempt, really kind of locked her down in turn number 2.
Now you'll notice we've got a couple of the Gorge Roller girls in the penalty box. A few things you can't do. You can't use your forearms on an opponent. You can't knock them over from behind. These are all things you will sit in that penalty box for 30 seconds, maybe more. And we've got number 1, 2, 3, Bragger, lead jammer for the Wreckers.
Feisty with some quick feet, looking to make some progress. Knocked out, she's gonna start again. Here, coming into the back of the pack, looking to pick her way through, but the Wreckers really, again, locking it down. Each one kind of taking a turn, saying, welcome to the hangar. She'll step out, have to restart it.
And Cracker, when she passes the first blocker, she gets points for the blockers in the box as well. Picking up another 5 points there and looking for more. Through on the inside, picking up another 5 points before she calls off the jam.
So Feisty really got locked down almost all the way around, one full revolution around the track. Not able to pick up any points in that last jam.
Oh, we've got number 76, Halitosis, lining up here against number 7, Judo Chop.
And number 76, that's Halitosis for the Wreckers. And here we go. Oh, look at that. Right onto the lead jam. Halitosis right to the inside and through.
Judo Chop seeing an open scene now on the inside. She is through now on her initial pass as well.
Oh, nicely done. Halitosis right to the outside. A 4-point pass. And she calls off that jam.
4 more points for the Rose City Wreckers on that one.
And it looks like both teams are back to full strength. The Pabst Blue Ribbon penalty box is now empty. On the line is B52, that's J-Bomb.
And she is taking on number 1055, Abracadabra. J-Bomb looking for an opening on the outside lane. Abracadabra going to the inside, but oh, J-Bomb right behind her. Taking that opening, picking up a lead jammer for the first time for the Gorge Roller Girls.
Oh, that was some really quick feet by J-Bomb getting onto the lead jam. Abracadabra right behind her, the pack moving very quickly. And there we go. The Mountain Mavens picking up
3 points.
And calling off that jam, 1 point for the Wreckers.
And we've got number 75, Sci-Fi Curious, lining up here for the Wreckers.
And that is 42, Feisty.
Lining up on that Tonkin Jammer line.
And here we go. Oh, Feisty looking inside, really getting locked up by the pack. The Wreckers putting some nice block on. But she is through to the inside. Oh, she stepped out. She's going to have to restart. And a penalty track cut on Feisty.
Sci-Fi Curious going around the outside of the pack there and calling off the jam, picking up her points. 4 points in the process of that one. I almost think maybe they didn't see her coming.
Well, and now what the Wreckers are going to be able to do, they're going to be able to start this jam in a power jam situation. So they've got the only jammer on the track, so she will be able to score. She's going to take as many points as she can. The Mountain Mavens are going to try and kill this penalty.
That's right, and we've got all of the blockers out of the penalty box to participate here.
Oh, there we go. Jack Rabbit really putting the block on.
Lauren Forster taking a tough hit out of bounds there on turn one. And she is through. She's your lead jammer for Rose City.
So it looks like Jackrabbit's elbow kind of got a little loose there. She's headed to the PBR penalty box.
Lauren Forster there. It's a great offense by her blockers there for clearing a path. That's 5 more points for Lauren Forster.
So here we go. Feisty served her penalty. She's now back on the track. She's now looking to make some headway.
Knocked out of bounds and doing very good and not getting that cut track penalty. And Lauren Forster picks up 4 more points for the Wreckers.
And Feisty breaks through. She's now going to be able to get to the back of the pack, start her scoring pass.
Amanda Sackerball on her way to the penalty box just as that jam is ending. The Rosie Rollers would like to thank Bike Punk, locally printed eco-friendly sticker signs and design. Visit bikepunk.com.
All right, here we go. It is number 7, Juba Chop for the Mountain Mavens. And that looks like Abracadabra 1055 on the line for your Rose City Wreckers.
Both teams will have Walker in the penalty box, but Abracadabra quickly picking up lead jammer for the Wreckers.
Here we go, Juba Chop looking to make her way around the track, looking inside one to beat, and she is through.
Abracadabra taking that outside lane to pick up 4 points, calling off the jam.
You know, I saw this the other night, Mistress Mouth, while there was a scrimmage going on, and the one team, they would score points and call off the jam before their opponent could score any points at all.
That is definitely the advantage to picking up a lead jammer, is that you can end that jam, keeping your opponent from picking up any points for their team.
So here we go, B52 J-Bomb on the line for the Mountain Mavens.
Taking on Kitka for the Wreckers.
And J-Bomb's looking to the outside, she gets knocked out. She's gonna have to start way back. She'll put a welt on, really making her work hard.
Kitka through, picks up lead jammer and sneaks up on the pack. Sneaks through, picking up a 5-point grand slam for the Wreckers.
So J-Bomb there headed to the PBR penalty box, a low block called, which gives the Wreckers another opportunity for a power jam.
That's another 30 seconds of unanswered points here for Kitka. That's 9-10 so far on this jam.
So here we go. We've got the Mountain Mavens setting up at the front of the pack, looking to put the brakes on Kitka, but she breaks through. That is another, looks like another 5-point pass for the Wreckers.
There was some excellent blocking there by Snow Loris, clearing a path for Kitka to pick up some points on that. Now she's going through looking for another scoring pass.
So here we go. Yep, there we go, one to beat. Kitka does, she is right through, 5 more points. She is just en fuego in this jam.
Smoking hot.
J-Bomb serves her penalty. She is back on the track and she is ready. And that's it. That jam went the distance. A 21-point pickup for the Rose City Wreckers.
And we have a team timeout. I believe that calls for a Mike Checks Music Minute. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, we've got raffle tickets on sale as we speak. $1 per ticket, 10 for $5, or your height in tickets for $20. We've got a basket worth over $500. You don't want to miss it.
You know, I think it's your height or the height of someone you can who is very tall that you can befriend quickly. Because my height would not get me any tickets at all. All right, here we go. It is Spice Tea on the line, number 42 for the Mountain Mavens.
Cracker jamming here for the Wreckers. And
there she goes, right onto the lead jam saw. Nice hole right on the inside line and takes it. Cracker skating fast though, looking to make up some ground. Oh, nicely done, Feisty, right on through.
Feisty getting tangled up there with number 26. Shimmy Coco Bop calling off the jam. Had enough of that.
And that is 3 points there for the Mountain Mavens.
Rose City Rollers would like to thank Bridgetown Chiropractic, the official chiropractor of the Rose City Rollers since the very beginning.
And here we go on the line, number 7, Judo Chop.
Taking on number 0, that's Zero Master, picking up Lead Jammer right off the bat for the Rose City Wreckers.
Oh, look at that, the Wreckers did a nice job, a nice little two block there. Locking Judo Chop down, letting Zero Master get onto the lead jam.
Zero Master gets knocked to the inside, decides to call it off to avoid that cut track penalty. And we will reset for the next one.
Well, you know, if you can prevent your opponent from scoring points while you're scoring them, that's a recipe for success.
That's smart derby right there. Speaking of smart, Kind Bars, snack like there's no tomorrow. Kind Snacks, check them out.
All right, it is J-Bomb B-52 for the Mountain Mavens, and it is the Rodent of Unusual Size right through onto the lead jam, just exploding through the pack. J-Bomb still working hard, trying to find some daylight, does, and is now ready to start her scoring pass.
I'd say she gnawed her way through that pack just again right now. Just chewing her way through that rodent of unusual size. 4 more points for the Wreckers.
Hey, if you're having a good time and you're interested in being a Wrecker for Rose City, think about playing Derby the next intake this weekend, November 14th. Skates and gear are available through Rent and Roll.
We've got number 214 on the line here for Rose City. That's V-Day Masker taking on Feisty for the Mountain Mavens.
Feisty looking to take the inside line. Gets knocked out. She's going to start again. Now look to the outside. Nice move around the pack. Oh!
V-Day Masker at the front of the pack, working her way through that wall of white Mavens. She's got 2 more to get around.
And there we go, Feisty.
Feisty's out of the pack, but V-Day Masker got out just first, picks up Lee Jammer, and sees that she has no advantage there, calls it off while she can.
I think that was a nice strategic call off. Feisty had gotten around her.
Something tells me she did that on purpose. Rose City Rollers would like to thank Voodoo Donut. The magic is in the hole. Proud sponsor of the Rose City Rollers and the Wheels of Justice.
All right, here we go on the line. It is number 7, Judo Chop, and 8008, Resting Blitz Face. Yeah, there's a little spill there in the middle of the track. Every skater's back up there, ready to go. And is Resting Blitzface right onto the lead jam. Judo Chop still looking for some daylight there through the pack. One to beat, and she does. Kitka tries to put a block on.
Resting Blitzface blasting through that back wall of white blockers, picking up the back block penalty. She will sit in the penalty box.
And here, the Mountain Mavens have another power jam opportunity. This might be the chance to get some momentum back. Judo Chop knocked out. They're going to drag her way back with Shell, put a welt on. At the back there, oh, big block by number 20. And they're going to start again.
The pack is at a standstill. Judo Chop with 2 more to get around here.
Oh, looks like Kitka and Colonel Korn.
Resting Blitzface out of the penalty box, gets her 4 points, and here she comes again for another.
But now Judo Chop picking up a track cut and headed to the penalty box.
That means power jam for the Wreckers here. 30 seconds of unanswered points for Resting Blitzface. Starting off with 4 on that last pass.
Oh no, my mistake. No track cut there for Judo Chop. She's still able to pick up some points.
But now it looks like we've got Resting Blitzface going back to the box now for cut track. That penalty pendulum likes to swing back and forth.
And here we go. Look at this. The Wreckers just putting the screws to Judo Chop. It was Colonel Korn and Shell put a welt on, and Kitka all just converging on her to put the stop on.
And when quality counts, call Bridgetown Automotive. Support the Rose City Rollers while taking great care of your car. That's Bridgetown Automotive.
So the Mountain Mavens starting this jam in a power jam situation, and it is J-Bomb B-52. She steps out, and Slow Loris is going to drag her way back and get her to start again. The pack's all tight there. People jostling for position.
They close the door on J-Bomb. You shall not pass. Still looking for an opening here.
Jackrabbit getting in there, trying to scrape blockers off. So J-Bomb gets a little daylight and through, and there she goes, right onto the lead jam.
Cracker and Slow Loris there, working her down, killing some of that penalty time. And there's going to be no points on that last pass.
I'm going to give some style points to Resting Blitzface. She had a nice little apex jump, but did not stick the landing, so lesser points there.
Did you know that every time we have a bout, you can get the best seats in the house? See those guys down there on that couch? Those are the best seats in the house. Those are auctioned off every time. Win that seat, admission for two, and drinks. Check out the seats auction on eBay. Thanks, guys.
Because you're going to be able to see the action here. It is Feisty 42 and Venus Envy. Feisty really just getting swallowed up by the blocking of the Wreckers. Oh, but nice quick feet to the outside. And she breaks through, is going to be ready to start her scoring pass. The Mountain Mavens have some numbers now.
Venus Envy getting knocked out of bounds right in front of that penalty box. She's going to get run back to the back of the pack. Recycled with Feisty as well. Venus Envy through the pack. That's four more points for the Wreckers. Feisty getting recycled to the back yet again.
And here in the pack, it's Halitosis and Abracadabber putting a nice block there on Feisty. She's not making any progress. Still looking for a way out. The Mountain Mavens not to be outdone. Really trying to put the stop on Venus Envy, not able to do so. She picks up another 5 points coming through the pack.
Feisty just getting knocked around on the inside lane there, and there goes Venus Envy through on that inside lane for five more for the Rose City Wreckers.
And there we go. Colonel Korn, one to beat. She does. That's 4 points. For Feisty and the Mountain Mavens.
Oh, and there goes Venus Envy getting called on that direction of gameplay penalty. She's gonna sit for 30 seconds. Another power jam here for the Mountain Mavens.
Woo! That jam was a marathon. 7 points for the Mountain Mavens at the end of that jam, 14 for the Rose City Wreckers.
We'd like to thank the OHSU Sports Medicine, proud to be the official medical care team of the Rose City Rollers. Thank you guys for being here, making sure that we're all safe and sound.
And here we go, the Wreckers are gonna start down their jammer, so that gives Judo Chop an opportunity for the Mountain Mavens to get into a power jam, and she does. Nicely done coming through the pack, finding the hole that was there for a split second, skates right on through. She's ready to start scoring some points.
Number 84 getting up in there, trying to clear space for, she's through, there's 5 more points for the Mavens.
Oh, 84 stabs and thing, really clearing a path to the inside. That's what you, if you're a jammer, that's what you want out of your blockers. You want them to make clear a hole for you if they can. Nicely done there for another 2.7 total for the Mountain Mavens.
We'd also like to thank Car2Go. Meet the future of car sharing. Sign up today at car2go.com.
All right, we're ready to start this jam. We've got J-Bomb, B-52, skating in the inside. Now looking outside, looking to make some headway, and does. Nicely done, right onto the lead jam. But Kitka skating fast. It's going to be a race to the pack to start scoring. And there we go. Look at that J-Bomb right on through.
J-Bomb trying to get through the pack to call off the jam, but it appears as though the jam continues as J-Bomb's going to the penalty box on a forearm penalty.
So we've got the Mountain Mavens setting up shop there at the top of the pack, really putting the stop on Kitka, but she's able to make it through. 5 points for the Rose City Wreckers, and also with a power jam going on. We've got the pack set. Oh, look at that, nice quick beat to the inside. Kitka, nicely done.
5 more points then with the lead jammer having gone to the penalty box. That means this jam will go the full 2 minutes.
So unfortunately, Duke Warrior made a little space for Kitka, but picked up a penalty in the process. 5 points there for Kitka. J-Bomb's back on the track. Gonna pick up some more points here. 4-point pass for the Mountain Mavens.
4 points right behind them for Kitka as well.
And unfortunately, Min Destructible picking up the penalty box, headed to the PBR penalty box. 4 more points for J-Bomb. And getting the pack back together.
As well.
And that'll do it for that jam, going the full two.
28 points for the Rose City Wreckers on that jam. And 10 for the Mavens as well. But we'd like to take a second to thank the PDX Pipeline, your online source for Portland's music, arts, and events happening. Check it out, the PDX Pipeline.
All right, here we go. We're ready to start. It is resting Blitz Face and number 29, Scoldy Knox for the Mountain Mavens.
Scoldy Knox getting stymied at the back of that pack behind that wall.
Oh, just a brutal circular wall there set by the Wreckers, really locking down Scoldy Knox.
And not even seeing resting Blitzface coming up on the pack there.
And there we go, Colonel Thorn and Cracker. Seeing the opportunity to set another nice triangle block there at the top of the pack, leaving Scoldy Knox with nowhere to go.
Arresting Blitzface, getting knocked to the outside and then back to the inside. Finds her opening, she's through the pack. That's a 5-point grand slam for Arresting Blitzface.
Min Destructible trying to scrape blockers off Scoldy Knox, but they just continue to recycle one another, leaving Scoldy Knox very little room to operate.
5 more to grand slam for Resting Blitzface.
And it looks like we had a low block there called. In the meantime, everyone kind of looking around. Resting Blitzface takes advantage right to the inside. Another 5-point pass. And here Scoldy Knox comes through. Looking to start her scoring. The pack there is set. Look at that, number 33, held a contempt, trying to make some space for Scoldy Knox boy, but that was a tough jam, tough blocking there, set by the Wreckers. That was a hard-earned 3 points by the Mountain Mavens. 24 more points for the Rutgers in that last jam opportunity.
And just want to take a half a second here to say Kelly Brown loves roller derby.
But no more, but not more than us.
I often wonder if that's possible. Oh, we've got number 10, that's Slow Loris. Jamming here for the Wreckers, knocked down on turn one. J-Ball picking up lead jammer for the Mavens.
And Slow Loris, not slow at all, coming around the track. But J-Bomb in the lead jam, looking to regain some momentum. Nicely done. The pack moving very quickly for her 4 points there. Slow Loris also working her way through another 4 points, but it is J-Bomb's jam. No, look at that. Nicely done to the outside.
Psychokinesis there, clearing a path on the outside for J-Bomb to cruise through, pick up some points, and call off the jam. We've got time for at least one more jam here in the first period with a minute and a half left on the period clock. We've got the Rose City Wreckers in the lead, 160 to the Gorge Roller Girls is 60.
And we have some really terrific contest. We have a terrific contest coming up at halftime, leg wrestling.
Don't forget to get your raffle tickets, ladies and gentlemen. That winner will be drawn during halftime.
And here we go, Judo Chop and Zero Master squaring off. Judo Chop looking to work to the front quickly, but it is Zero Master with one to beat. And she is on to the lead jam, and here comes Judo Chop. Zero Master taking a quick peek back to see where Judo Chop is in relation to the pack. And each are ready to start some scoring, and it is Zero Master right on through.
High block being called on number 10 there. That's Jackrabbit. Or maybe not.
And here we go. It is 483, the Doof Warrior, and 42, Feist T. Ready to get this jam on. Standing at the Ron Tonkin jammer line. Each skater so quick, and look at that Doof Warrior keeping her feet right to the inside. Number 29, Scoldy Knox, trying to slow her down, but no such luck.
Doof Warrior with a light, nice little hop around onto Mame. She's got 5 points and a grand slam for the Wreckers.
And here we got Shell put a welt on and crack her.
She gets around Stamson and picks up another 5 points for the Wreckers.
Feist T looking to start again. Oh, quick strategic move by number 20. Shell put a welt on, inducing the track cut. That's going to send Feist T to the PBR penalty box and leave Doof Warrior on out there for a power jam. And this jam looks like it's going to go the full two.
Oh, but we have Doof Warrior now in the penalty box, and that will spring Feist T immediately. Doof Warrior will only have to serve as much penalty time as Feist T did. Those are the jammer rules, folks. Really no point to only having, there's no point to having both jammers in the box now, is there?
And right there in the pack, the Wreckers setting a nice triangular block, nice positional blocking set. They're going to recycle. They're going to get themselves to the front and really lock down Feist T, who steps out, and it is Crack Her recycling her back. She's going to have to start again.
And that's 20 points on the jam thus far for Doof Warrior.
Look at that Mountain Maven set up at the front of the pack. Puts the stop on, and that'll do it for...
All right, ladies and gentlemen, and with that, it is halftime. Don't go away. We've got leg wrestling for our halftime show. We've got raffle basket to give away. Don't go away.
All right. Here we go. It is period number two of this first night of derby action on this long weekend. We've got number 7, Judo Chop, on the line for the Mountain Mavens.
Taking on Abracadabra for the Wreckers. There goes Abracadabra picking up a lead at Jammer for the Wreckers to start off the second period. Judo Chop now out of the pack on her initial pass.
And here we go. Oh, look at that. Abracadabra right to the inside line. No one paying attention. She just skates right through. Calls off that jam.
The next jam will start with the Mavens with two blockers in the penalty box. That will be a 2-on-4 pack advantage to the Wreckers. And again, the Jammers only have to pass the first opponent to pick up points for the ones in the box.
So it is Feist T, number 42, and Zero Master squaring off. Zero Master right onto the lead jam, quickly through the pack. Feist T looking to still pick her way through.
Feisty getting knocked around by Spectre Gadget in there. Slow Loris helping out, and V-Day Massacre. Feisty now out of the pack on her initial pass. Zero Master working on points. A hard hit there to Zero Master by number 10, Jack Rabbit. And Zero Master's had enough of that jam. Calls it off.
Four points there for the Wreckers. Jack Rabbit had put a nice block on Zero Master.
Rosie Rollers would like to thank the Buffalo Gap Saloon and Eatery, John's Landing's favorite eatery and saloon. Check them out, show them some derby love.
And here we go. We've got J-Bomb
out in front, and she picks up lead jammer. V-Day Massacre still hung up in the back of the pack. She's taken that star off, handing it over to her pivot there. That is a star pass.
And J-Bomb looking to skating with some authority right on through. 4 points picked up as she comes through the pack.
That star passed over to Venus Envy for the Wreckers. J-Bomb working on points here. Puts up 4 more. And we have a cut track call being called on Venus Envy. Power jam for the Mountain Mavens.
Oh, there we go. Scoldinox looking to clear some space to the outside. J-Bomb following right on through. Is Duke Warrior last one to beat? She has to let her go. 5-point pass for the Mountain Mavens.
The Mountain Mavens coming out strong here in the second half, trying to close that score gap. And with that, 5 more points for the Mountain Mavens.
Shell put a welt on. RUS tried to bring the brakes, but couldn't. J-Bomb just push it, just gets right on through there, blocking to pick up those points, skating with a lot of authority here in this jam. And it is Duke Warrior. She has to let her go, and she does. And J-Bomb on for 4 more points.
And we've got a jammer race on our hands, and J-Bomb doesn't like it. She calls it off.
Oh, that was a great jam there. The Mountain Mavens is just what they needed. 22-point pickup. Nicely done.
The Broxity Rollers would like to thank the friendly people at Echo Construction. They love custom home building remodels and roller derby. Check them out in the program. And we've got resting Blitzface here against Judo Chop in the second period. Judo Chop held up at the back behind that wall of black. Blitzface up at the front with one more to get around. She's done it. She's your lead jammer.
So Mountain Mavens really did a nice job at the top of the pack to stop, to slow Resting Blitzface down, but she eventually just breaks on through and gets on to the lead jam. Judo Chop still trying to make her way through the pack. Nice triangular blocking there at the top of the pack, set by the Wreckers.
Resting Blitzface looking for that opening, gets it on the outside. One more to get around. She gets around Jack Rabbit, and that's four more points for your Rose City Wreckers.
And it looks like we've got a star pass to Stabsinthy. What a track cut there, and we're going to see another power jam set by the Wreckers, 5 points.
Number 84, that's Stabsinth, going to the penalty box for the Mountain Mavens. Power jam here for Resting Blitzface. And that's 5 in a grand slam.
Here we go, right to the inside. Look at that, nicely done. Number 2, looking to clear a space, but Jack Rabbit's seat picks it up, escorts Resting Blitzface out. She has to start again.
And time will run out on that jam. We'd like to take a second to thank Black Cat Plumbing, your local neighborhood plumbing company, and a proud part of the Rose City Rollers since 2009. That's Black Cat Plumbing.
Meow!
Meow!
Hey, but let's put our hands together and give a big shout out to all of our volunteers who make Derby possible.
Woohoo! And we heard we have Feisty taking on Halitosis. Feisty picking up lead jammer for the Gorge Roller Girls. Halitosis is right behind her, and we've got a jammer race.
Man, oh, nicely done. Feisty quickly through the pack to the inside and calls off the jam. 3 points there for the Mountain Mavens. You know, if you want to volunteer, you can become a part of the magic that's RCR. Just go to the Rose City Rollers website and check out all the opportunities for you to become a part of the league. Sign up and get involved today. It's because of our volunteers that we're able to do this, and we thank them very much, especially our DJ tonight, Tom Tom.
And we've got Slow Horse taking the lead jammer right off the bat here over J-Bomb. But again, we're going to have a jammer race, and it looks like Slow Loris is putting herself into a blocking position a little bit there, decides to call off the jam because she doesn't like her advantage. We'd like to thank Timothy Murray Photography. Visit timothymurrayphotography.com for classic black and white film derby images. That's timothymurrayphotography.com.
All right, on the line, we've got 42 Feisty and 75 Sci-Fi Curious. Sci-Fi Curious starts outside, goes inside, and right into the lead jam. Feisty getting locked up at the back of the pack. Some, again, nice positional blocking by the Wreckers.
Shell put a welt on, just stopping Feisty. And now we've got number 26, Shimmy Coco Pop, chasing her through the pack, but they got to let her go. She's through on her initial. And there goes Sci-Fi Curious, picking up 4 more points for the Wreckers.
And she will call that jam off. Hey, let's say thanks to Radar Wheels, a proud partner of the Wheels of Justice, and also the Starlight Knitting Society, who, and they invite you to explore their gorgeous new shop, open on Southeast 52nd at Bybee. All right, here we go. It is number 7, Judo Chop.
Taking on Cracker for the Wreckers.
Oh, just a quick step, and it is Cracker onto the lead jam. But it is Judo Chop fast behind. Look at that, nicely done right to the inside. Picks up those points, 4 points, and calls off that jam. What a fast jam that was.
Yep, Packerly picking up the speed there. And we would like to thank the Laurelhurst Theater and Pub, the best of modern cinema, independent art, and classic film to Portland's movie lovers. Again, that's Laurelhurst Theater and Pub.
All right, we are set and ready to go. It is 76 Haley Tosis and B-52 J-Bomb on the line.
J-Bomb knocked to the outside, recycled to the pack while Haley Tosis picks up a lead jammer for the Wreckers.
Here we go, J-Bomb looking to make it through the pack. The Wreckers setting up at the top of it. Looking outside, makes it on through.
Haley Tosis right behind her, picking up points. Calling off the jam, getting that four in there and calling it off.
So we're also going to say thanks to our league sponsors, the Portland Mercury, Portland Vital Signs, City Graphics, and Kay's Bar. If you're feeling hungry, Kay's Bar just down to our right, your left, serving up some delicious food at tonight's bout. That's Kay's Bar.
And we've got, that's Feisty taking on Doof Warrior down there on the Tonkin.com jammer line.
Oh, some nice quick feet there by Feisty, able to break through onto the lead jam, but boy, Doof Warrior coming so fast, she has to call that jam off.
Want to thank Socket To Me. Be awesome, wear awesome at SocketToMe.com. Proud sponsor of the Rose City Rollers. I ordered some socks from them today. I like socks.
I am wearing some actually right now. I've got my ninja socks on.
Ninja socks. And just like a ninja, Lauren Forster sneaking around the outside. No pass, no penalty, as she is your lead jammer.
So Judo Chop stepping out, having to start again. The Wreckers setting up there, looking to put the brakes on. The Mountain Mavens also looking to put some stop.
Judo Chop through the pack on her initial pass, and Lauren Forster looking for points. Going around the outside, gets around Carmen Elitrekia and calls off the jam. Also want to thank CrossFit Magnus, official fitness partner of the Wheels of Justice.
All right, this jam's on. It's B-52 J-Bomb for the Mountain Mavens. And
V-Day Massacre trying to get through that wall of white up there at the front with a nice braced four wall.
Look at that, a nice four wall set by the Wreckers. Abracadaver sending J-Bomb way on back.
V-Day Massacre pushing through the pack. They finally got to let her go. She is your lead jammer.
Oh, and there we go. J-Bomb through Jack Rabbit. Really kind of clearing a path to the outside. She follows through the pack nice and tight there across the track.
V-Day Massacre having a bit of a tough time getting around Jack Rabbit. Decides to call off the jam after picking up 2 points for the Wreckers. Once again, we'd like to thank Kind Bars, a brand of all-natural whole nut and fruit bars made from ingredients you can see and pronounce. We'd also like to thank 4K No Amazing Tacos with 2 locations on Mississippi and Hawthorne. Feisty here up against Resting Blitzface. Resting Blitzface taking the lead jammer.
And there we go, Feisty. Oh, a nice little duck and move right through the pack. Rutgers setting up at the top of the pack. And that quick jam comes to an end with resting Blitzface calling that off.
Oh, but she is sent to the penalty box for, I believe, direction of gameplay. Womp womp.
Hey, let's say thanks to New Belgium Brewing Company, Fat Tire Ale or Ranger IPA. Grab one at concessions down below us. And hey, Joe's Burgers, 4 locations, awesome burgers, and the official feeder of RCR.
J-Bomb breaking through the front of the pack there, picking up lead jammer for the Mountain Mavens. Arresting Blitzface still hanging out in that PBR penalty box.
The Rutgers had set up at the top of the pack. Scoldylocks trying to get in there, scrape some blockers off, letting J-Bomb through. 5-point pickup for the Mountain Mavens.
The Wreckers are bracing up at the front of the pack to stop J-Bomb. One more to get around. She's through. There is 5 more points for the Mavens.
Yeah, Duke Warrior had to let her go. That's a 5-point pickup. Now, and resting Blitzface served her penalty. She's back on the track. She steps out, has to start again.
5 more points there in the air for J-Bomb.
Here we go, Wreckers setting up a nice triangle block there at the top of the pack. Dufoyer looking to block her, has to let her go. Another 5-point pickup in this jam. J-Bomb really pouring it on here, 20 points already. Looking for a little more as this jam is gonna go the distance. There we go, look at that 5-point pass.
Arresting Blitzface with that star stashed in her hand, trying to hand that off to, that would be number 00 Master. Meanwhile, 4 more points in the air for J-Bomb.
And that's that jam, a full 2 minutes, that's it. J-Bomb, a big 29-point pickup. Woo! Mountain Mavens representing the Gorge Roller Girls.
Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, if you have not gotten your fill of roller derby this evening, we've got tomorrow right here at the Hangar, 6 p.m., the Rosebuds with a doubleheader, all 4 of the home teams knocking the snot out of each other right here on the flat track. It's going to be a good time.
And here we go, it is Slow Loris and Judo Chop, and it's Slow Loris, not slow at all, through the pack, onto the lead jam. Judo Chop, the Wreckers really have her number. Set a nice block there. And Slow Loris right to the inside, 5 points.
The Wreckers line of defense just shutting down Judo Chop.
And Mindestructible looking to help Judo Chop out, but the Wreckers just relentless in their positional blocking, and it is the Slow Loris 10-10 right on through, another 5-point pickup.
The Mountain Mavens trying to reset here to put a stop to Slow Loris. Meanwhile, at the front of the pack with the Wreckers slowing down Judo Chop.
Little tumble there, and number 26, Shimmy Cocobop headed to the penalty box.
Mindestructible going up against Slow Loris there. She's like, I may be shorter than you, but I can slow you down. Wow, that's gonna do it for that jam.
That is another 4 points for the Wreckers.
Again, wanna thank the Tonkin.com for sponsoring our jammer line. The largest selection of new and used autos in the Pacific Northwest is only a click away at Tonkin.com.
On the Tonkin Jammer line, we've got 42 Feisty for your Mountain Mavens and 214 V-Day Massacre. Looking to just kind of push on through that pack. Really, the Mountain Mavens really tightened up there. Really getting V-Day Massacre stopped up. And Feisty is taking advantage, skating quickly through.
Getting a little bit brutal down there, Feisty, with two more to get around. But here comes the pivot, taking over that star cover. That's number four, Spectre Gadget.
And that is 5 points for Feisty. A nice Feisty skate there for the Mountain Mavens, putting 5 points up on the board, but more importantly, preventing the Wreckers from scoring any points. There's plenty of time. Anything can happen. That's the beauty of roller derby. And it looks like number 10, Jack Rabbit,
jamming up against number 1, 2, 3. That's Cracker, picking up lead jammer. Oh, and we've got a Maven pile up there. Couple of Mavens. And Venison be getting sent probably for a low block.
One to beat. There we go. 3 point pass for Cracker, 4 points for Jack Rabbit, as that jam comes to an end.
We'd like to thank Joe's Burgers with 4 locations, Awesome Burgers, and the official feeder of the Rose City Rollers Volunteers. Show them some loving. Joe's Burgers.
Oh, yeah.
Now I'm hungry.
All right, here we go.
Duke Warrior here for the Rose City Wreckers up against J-Bomb for the Mavens.
J-Bomb, some quick feet through that pack, but just running into a big, dark wall of Wreckers.
J-Bomb getting run to the back. And there goes Duke Warrior, picking up a lead jammer for the Wreckers. J-Bomb with 2 more to get around. She is through on her initial pass.
And nice little bump, abracadaver, clearing some space for the Duke Warrior.
Calling it off. We'd like to thank the Nightlight Lounge, Rose City's Rollers' favorite Clinton Street bar, and the only place to get your Rose City Rollers tickets right here in town. That's the Nightlight Lounge. Also want to thank Hope Baraka Realtor, helping Portlanders buy and sell their dream house. That's Hope Baraka Realtor.
Oh, Feisty, look to the outside. That hole closed very quickly. She steps out. It's going to have to recycle and start again.
Lauren Forster picking up lead jammer for the Wreckers.
And it looks like a back block there on Feisty. She's going to head to the PBR penalty box. In the meantime, Lauren Forster skating through, looking to the inside, a 5 point pass and a power jam.
Taking her time to get nice and clean through that pack, no penalties. She doesn't want to give up this power jam advantage. And a nice spin move through the front of the pack, and that's 5 more points for the Wreckers.
And here we go. Mountain Mavens setting up shop there at the top of the pack. They're going to look to stop Lauren Forster from making any more progress. And Scoldy Knox, the last one to beat, says nope.
No pass, no penalty there. 4 more points. She doesn't get the full 5. And Feisty back to the penalty box for a cut track.
And here we go. The pack very tight. Lauren Forster skates through. Scoldy Knox takes aim. Big swing and a miss.
Was looking like setting up for some passive offense, but they get in there. They clear a path on the inside. but not before Lauren Forster takes the cut track penalty, and she is beyond the point of no return, which is why she has to go all the way around before her penalty time will start.
And that'll do it for that jam. 4 points for Lauren Forster there at the end of that jam, 19-point pickup. Hey, you know, if you've enjoyed this evening, pick up some RCR merch down at the merch table.
Damn Skippy.
My left, your right. Some great stuff there for sale.
We've got Jackrabbit here in the power start for the Mountain Mavens. She's got lead jammer.
I think this power jam comes at a really good time for the Mountain Mavens.
Absolutely. 128 to 283, 4 minutes left in the second period.
One to beat. Slow Loris.
Oh, Jackrabbit getting tangled up with the ref there. She's on her way out now. She's got 5 in the air.
So it's 5 points for Jackrabbit of the Mountain Mavens, and what nice skating right to the inside.
That record star passed over to Spectre Gadget, forcing the call off by the Mountain Mavens.
A nice 10-point pickup for the Mountain Mavens. And here we come to the line. It is B-52 J-Bomb and 578 Kitka.
Kitka here looking for an opening on the outside, but J-Bomb gets up to the front, picks up lead jammer. Now we have a jammer race. And Kitka takes down J-Bomb, forcing J-Bomb to call off the jam. No points either jammer. Rose City Rollers want to thank Shebop, a female-friendly sex toy boutique right here in Portland, Oregon. That's Shebop. Check them out.
And Viva La Aardvark!
Viva La Aardvark!
Secret Aardvark Trading Company, world flavors produced locally.
Delicious. Duke Warrior here. Taking on, that's number 33, held to contempt, jamming for her first time this evening, and she is just plowing through that front line of blockers. Oh, knocked to the inside, is gonna get recycled to the back.
And they're looking to bring the pack back together. Duke Warrior, one to beat Jackrabbit. She's got to let her go. And it is Duke Warrior on to the lead jam. In the meantime, held to contempt, just getting swallowed up by the pack. But ah, Daylight, one to beat, and she does.
And we are down to the last 2 minutes of this game. Ladies and gentlemen, make some noise for these Derby girls. Whistle after whistle after whistle.
In the meantime, Duke Warrior just skating on through. 4-point pickup. Held to contempt, staying focused on this jam. Also, 4 points coming through.
A pile up in the penalty box. Not enough chairs for all of the penalized blockers. And we have an official review as being called by the Mountain Mavens. Dolomite will run down to the floor and find out what's going on. In the meantime, again, we would like to thank Bridgetown Chiropractic, again, the official chiropractor of the Rose City Rollers since the beginning.
Yeah.
Our 2016 season passes are on sale starting, or will go on sale. No, it's November now. Yeah, November 1st are on sale, 36 bouts for less than the cost of 18. Check it out online.
So the request was, the Mountain Mavens are asking the officials to call a track cut on the Rutgers on their initial pass.
All right, so our referees will confer on that matter and let us know. Each team gets a one official review. If they are granted their official review, they get to a second one. If not, if they were wrong, then they lose that official review for the period. And of course, it's the end of the game, so this would be the last chance. Our head ref, Il Presidente, will bring the captains and coaches back together to give them the verdict.
All right, the officials have talked it over. No call will stand.
And with that, the Mavens will not retain their official review for the rest, for the whole minute and a half left of this game. Ish. Yeah, that wasn't the whistle. That was just the end of the timeout whistle. The next whistle will start the jam.
And it looks like the Rutgers are going to start with a definite pack advantage. And it is Haley Tosis right on out to the lead jam with J-Bomb trying to stay close. Knocked down, picks herself back up, looking to break through the pack, but oh, it's Haley Tosis right to the inside.
Making it look easy.
Some tough blocking set by the Rutgers. J-Bomb not finding any daylight, and there she does. She makes it through. 5 points for Haley Tosis. And she's gonna call that off.
And we have a timeout being called by the Rose City Rutgers, which means we'll have time for one more jam. And we will set up for one more jam. Derby fans, how about we make some noise?
All right, here we go. It is 84 Stapsinthe for the Mountain Mavens.
Taking on Cracker for the Rose City Rutgers. Stapsinthe getting knocked to the inside, and there goes Cracker picking up lead jammer, checking that clock, calling off the jam. And that is gonna end the game, ladies and gentlemen. We will wait for the official score, but I think it's pretty safe to say that the Rose City Rutgers are gonna take the win tonight. Don't go away. We'll be right back with you with our MVPs. Don't forget, we've got the juniors doubleheader tomorrow night, 6 o'clock. The Rosebuds invite you all to come out.
All right, here we go. We've got a final score, 306, 142. Let's make some noise for your Rose City Wreckers as they come around on their victory lap. All right, and let's put our hands together and say thanks to the Mountain Mavens representing the Gorge Roller Girls. All right,
if we could get both team captains down here in the middle for our announcement of MVPs.
So we're going to have a couple MVPs. You want to stick around for this. We're going to have MVPs for blockers and jammers. So let's get...
All right, Wreckers, who is your MVP blocker?
MVP blocker goes to number 10.
Number 10!
Jack Rabbit! And your MVP jammer?
Goes to number
42. 42! Feisty, your MVP jammer for the Mountain Mavens!
Captain.
All right, here we go.
All right, and who is your MVP blocker from the Wreckers?
Blocker is gonna be 008.
Number 00, that's 8008. And Interesting Blitzface. And your MVP jammer.
578.
Number 578.
Kickoff.
Congratulations, ladies. Please stick around to have your picture taken. On behalf of the Rose City Rollers and the Wreckers, ladies and gentlemen, I'm Mistress Mouth. With Dolomite, we thank you for coming out. Please come back tomorrow to watch our Junior's doubleheader, 6 o'clock. We'll see you then. Good night, everybody.